Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of ScrotitusPlays Minecraft. How you guys doing today? We are hanging out here inside of our base, our house. I guess this is, we still need some decorations and whatnot, but this chest you guys have been pretty familiar with. I've got some pretty awesome gear, including my bad bleep bow. Punch 2, Unbreaking 3, Power 3. You can probably guess how I got these things. This dual spawner that we had, I got that set up. But I want to show you this chest right here. We got a pretty good haul here, and you might be able to guess where we got this stuff from. We've got a bunch of saddles. Some horse armor, including diamond armor, a bunch of gold swords, a gold chest piece, a couple iron, couple gold, some diamonds. We got all this stuff from a nether fortress that we finally found. Yeah, it's only taken me forever, but we finally got it. So there's plenty of good stuff there. I didn't loot anywhere near all of what was available in that. It's one of the biggest fortresses in the nether that I think I've ever found, so I look forward to building some cool stuff around that, including some mechanics for wither skeletons spawning, and I have another idea too that I may implement there. I'm not positive, but let's get down to what today's episode is going to be all about, and that is our water tower. I think we're finally going to finish it, guys. Between that and the idea of an aqueduct system to work alongside with that water tower and the crop harvesting. So let's make our way up to what we've got built so far, the water tower. And there's a hillside here. And what we're planning on doing is building a tunnel through this hillside. This is going to be the main road of the village. It's going to go through this tunnel and come out the other side. I'm sort of inspired because my daily commute, I have to drive through a set of tunnels to get to work. And so I figure, why not, incorporate a little bit of tunnel action into my my world here. So that road is actually leads to our nether portal and hopefully where our castle is going to be filling up that hillside. In the near future and the distant future. It's going to take a while to build that. But yeah, so the idea that we've got going on here is we've got the startings of our water tower, and we're going to have water flowing down out of it, or dropping out of it, I guess I should say, into the aqueduct below. And then that is going to feed into our different harvest methods. Let me go down here real quick. I need to finish this off with some trapdoors probably, but we made some permanent stairs here in between each one of our farms. We kind of finished everything off in terms of look. Now the functionality is not there, and to finish that we need the water. So but yeah, we've got our pumpkins, and they've got green glass, and we've got yellow glass for our wheat and orange for our carrots. We went ahead and built like these little nooks behind each set of stairs. I'm not 100% certain what I'm doing with it yet, but it leaves some room for us to go ahead and expand. And then the two entries have these little backdoor walkways, I guess would be the way to describe that. But yeah, I laid out the length of our aqueduct, but that's about it so far. All right, so is there anything else in here that we're going to need? A couple things. I don't even know if we're going to actually get around to using most of this. Grab those jack-o'-lanterns and get rid of a couple things. I think that looks pretty good. We're going to grab our crafting bench here and take it up with us. So, look out for that. I'm pretty excited to get this ball rolling. Largely because I am tired of actually having to harvest the food myself. And once we get the water over to those pieces, then I want to set up at least what I'm going to call partial automation. And what I mean by that is, I think I discussed this in an earlier episode, but I want to trigger the crops to harvest according to a daylight sensor. So as soon as it gets a signal that's strong enough for daylight, it would send a pulse to definitely the pumpkin farm. I want to set up a reed farm that would function the same way. And we will see about the wheat and the carrots. The only reason I'm skeptical about those is because if we harvest them once and I don't get around to replanting the next time they harvest, I could potentially go days or time without any crops growing, and that's not really ideal. So anyway, I blabbed about the crop situation. Let's talk about our water tower here. Right now, what I'm doing is I'm trying to establish a somewhat decent pattern for a support structure for our water tower. Now, originally when I started building this, I was thinking of building a water tower in terms of what you would see nowadays in towns and towns and counties across America, where there's sort of like these big dome things on top of these four stilt legs. And the more I thought about that was, that's not really going to fit into our theme here, which we've clearly stated our theme is steampunk, and that's the build and style that we're trying to build along. So thinking back to that time, and actually, I need to finish this area off a little bit, so I think stairs actually function the best. We could do regular blocks, but then that would be a spawning hazard, so I think we're just going to throw some steps on each one of these. But anyway, if you think of the era that steampunk is based off of, which is, I believe, early Victorian, maybe late, but what they had in those days on top of their buildings were water towers. They were smaller, and they were basically essentially large barrels that housed water on top of buildings. Actually, that may be post-Victorian era. Yeah, that definitely is post, but that's the style that we're going with. Anyway. Excuse me, this cold. I've had this cold for, I don't know, close to 3 weeks. It's been kicking. So that's part of the reason why the episodes haven't been coming out as well. Actually, my entire family is sort of fighting off this cold. I'm actually in the best of health of the four of us, but it's been a nasty one, to say the least. But anyway, that's the game plan, is to model it off of those barrel type water towers that rest, that basically they use gravity to pump their water. And so that's what we're going to do. We're using that same theme here, where we're going to build this ginormous barrel on top of our four legs foundation and lookout that we have built here. And then we're going to have spouts that open up that allows water to rush down. And the only one that we're currently going to be setting up that way is going to be with the aqueduct system. So I'm actually going to go ahead and give us a cut right now. I've got a good foundation going here. I've got a good bit of work, though, and I don't want to bore you guys too much with all of that. So, like I said, sit tight, guys. I'm going to go ahead and cut here, and I will get back to you guys in a jiffy. All right, guys, welcome back. So we are back up on this super tall tower here. We've got a nice foundation here, including a little bit of pumpkin lighting. Now, this isn't actually for any other purpose than to allow us to see this sort of beacon of hope from any of the lands around us. Sort of gives me a visual aid as to where our village is. We built it on a small hillside, but then it's also about 20 blocks in the air. And with this water tower, we're going about 10 more. Actually, it's about 35 actually blocks in the air. And then this water tower or water tank on top of it is going to be another 10 to 15. So it's about 50 blocks high, and it's already on a hillside, so it's going to be a nice visual cue, day or night, basically, is what we're getting at here, to be able to see this beacon at, or designator of where our town is. So we're using the spruce wood here, and we're going to switch actually from the spruce over into a regular oak wood. And my thought for that being, if you think back to when these barrels would have been used to store any sort of liquid, it doesn't necessarily have to be water, but liquid nonetheless. And what happens is the level at which the water sits at would stain or make the wood discolored and darker in most cases. And that's what we're going to try to portray here. The bottom layers here are going to be the layers where the water actually was. And then the upper layers would be the dry layers. And so it would be a lighter color of wood. That's the illusion we're going for. So, oh, that was a mistake. So we're actually going to fill up this bottom layer for right now. That actually will be the only layer that we do, just because our ice is it's actually pretty low. I've used it in a couple projects now, including the dual spawner, which I plan on taking you guys back down and showing you what we did to finish that off, including what's called a mob softener. It's actually kind of fun. I did one in my old vanilla series, but that was a really long time ago. And this one is actually totally different with the technology and redstone that's used to make it function. So we're going to go over that in a near episode. But this is kind of what I had in mind, and it's actually working out really well in terms of the water coming down out of the top and then branching off. I thought I was going to have to put a block in the middle of this to make it branch around, but it looks like it's already doing the hard work for me. So what I'm thinking about doing next is sort of closing in the lookout tower portion of it, but I want to head down here to the ground and sort of take a peek at what we've got so far. And see if it's going to fit into the scale and scheme of what we had planned. So it's kind of hard to get a view of things from directly below. So let's get up on our little mini hill over here and take a peek at it from afar. I like it. You know what? I thought it would be a little bit different. I think if we make the top part go up more and make this look sort of like a chalice of a cup, I think it's going to work out almost exactly how we want it. So let me get fed up here and grab whatever other resources we need to get this job finished, and I'll meet you guys back up at the tower. All right, so I've done a little bit of work here. We're just wrapping things up with finishing touches on the lookout side of things. We made some spruce fencing that we are putting down. And then we're just using a combination of stone slabs and a block of polished andesite to sort of match what we did around the base outside. So what you would be able to see from down below. And I think it actually looks pretty good. It's a nice mix of materials and textures. So I think that works. It also is going to look good from the ground. We're going to add another light source to prevent any sort of spawning up here. I think we should be good because the only spaces that are spawnable, or actually I'm not sure if there's any. Looking around, it looks like most of them are half slabbed. I may be wrong, but the other thought then that I had is putting these grates in. Basically sort of making it look like, not like a faucet, but a grate would be the right word. And that actually doesn't look the way that I was hoping that it would. But these will be the areas that we actually distribute the water from. I may actually move it out one more. And looking at where this is dropping from, I don't know. We're also going to have to do something. I'm going to have spouts coming off of each side. Glass spouts, mind you. And right now, I actually don't have any glass in my inventory to build that part. That'll have to wait until we're able to get down and grab a little bit more glass. But I think the finishing touch... what is this? All right, actually, change of plans, guys. I'm actually going to have to take care of this. Yeah, let me go ahead and jump out again real quick, take care of this water so that it is proper, and then we'll get up top and finish this project up. All right, so I thought better of what I had planned and decided to go ahead and just wrap things up without you guys, because you probably didn't want to watch me drop down 100 or so wood blocks in a circle, you know, shape. That's pretty boring stuff. So let's slay a couple zombies here and just check out our finished product from our vantage point here on Little Round Top. I don't know. It's probably not even a round hill, so it's probably a dumb name, but it just came to me from my childhood. Gettysburg. I don't know if you guys are familiar with what Gettysburg was, so let's... In honor of Gettysburg and the Civil War that happened there, let's take out some of these skeletons and creepers. And whammy. Let's get this guy whammo. Whammy. Oh, no. Let's try it again. Boom. There we go. All right. Let's collect up our experience because we are actually sitting kind of low. We're going to need it. Oh, and there's a little sneak peek, a little cheat shot. Let's take this guy out. Maybe he'll give us some armor. One, two. Oh, he's got enchanted armor on. Three. Should only take two shots. Oh, we got it. Cool. We got a helmet. This will look good, actually, in our armor statue in the base. What is it? Oh, it's not enchanted. Dang it. Well, anyway, there's our finished product of our water tower, guys. What do you think? Be honest. Don't hold back. Let me know what you think of the design, look, and feel. Let me get rid of this guy real quick. Oh, and the money shot from far away. Boom, got him. Yeah, let me know if you like the design, if you like the concept, the functionality, if there's anything we can add to it. Just throw that in the comments, guys. And if you enjoyed the episode, go ahead and hit that like button too, because it does help me out and the channel out tremendously. But yeah, I want to thank everybody for the views and support that I have been getting. I'd like to see some more comments from you guys. So if you have anything that you want to see me build or do, there was some talk about going through the first season's world. We may do that in a future episode. So keep the ideas coming. And I want to thank you guys again for all the support that I've gotten so far this season. And I hope you're enjoying it. So this has been ScrotitusPlays Minecraft, and I'll check you guys in the next episode.